Okay, so let's start the final part. So actually, so this lecture so on OpenMP is until tomorrow noon. So I think we have enough time for some exercise. Okay, so today, so I will do some points. So I would like you to do some exercise. Because so far, I have not so much time. We have not so much time for so accessing the supercomputers. So you can get more experiences using supercomputers and also NTU cluster. So let's try the next part. So next part is the parallel version of the OpenMP. So we have just implement coloring to the original code, but that is not parallelized. So the next step is just insert some OpenMP pragma or OpenMP directive to the L2 solve, which we just I just introduced. Okay. So actually, so if you directly insert the OMP pragma in the L2 solve, it's okay. But so we have some modification in later stage. So considering that situations, we introduce the explicit number of threads. So the number name of the variable is a PSMP dot. This is a number of threads. So this is a input data and can be controlled in the program. So that means we input the this thread number explicitly from the code. The fundamental idea is meshes in the same color or same level are independent. Therefore, the parallel and the concurrent processing is possible for these meshes, as I mentioned yesterday. Okay, so this is a case for the. So I think. It's not good for me to giving a lecture in sitting. So it's better for me to standing. So I do the lecture by standing position. So in that case, I need this facilities. Just a moment. Okay. So this is a initial mesh. So from the 64. So let's think about this. So we have four colors and four threads. Okay. So we have four colors here. So this is a multi-coloring in four colors. Okay. So this is a initial number. So next is we renumber the meshes according to the color ID. So the first color here is a pink. Is a 1 to 16. The yellow color is the second color for the 17 to 32. And the blue one is the 33 to 48. And the final color, fourth color, is the green from 49 to 64. Okay, so next thing is that we distribute the meshes on each color to each thread. Okay, so we have two levels of the distributing the meshes on each thread. So if you consider the first color from the the first one to 16, so we have four threads. So in this case, we can distribute the four meshes for each thread in order to attain the load balancing. So as I mentioned, meshes in the same colors and same level are independent. So parallel and concurrent processing is possible for these meshes. And the renumbered meshes are assigned to the thread. Okay, so in this case, the first four meshes are to the thread 0, and the second, 5 to 8, is thread 1, and 9 to 12 is a thread 2, and the final thread, thread 3, provides the 13 to 16. Okay. So this is a very so usual way. So you can so apply the different way of the distributing the meshes. So for example, something like a so cyclic applying method. But so this type of the method is most popular because so in each thread the numbering is continuous and it's much better for so utilizing the cache. Okay, so that's why so usually we apply this type of distribution for each thread. Okay, so if you go to the supercomputers, so you can find the file. Okay. Okay, so first of all, please log into the so system, so supercomputer or NTU cluster. So you can find the several directories under the so directory multi-core. So you have three directories. So if you go to the L3, so you have several directories there. So among that, so you go to the so L3 slash SRC, okay, and so there you type make. So you can find the so execution file in the neighboring directory run run. The name is the L3 sol. Then so you go to the so run directory. So you can modify input .dat and also go1.sh. So this is a so shell script for running the code of this one. Okay, so I think so you may have a several directory like this under the L3, run src, src0, src x, and reorder0. So now so you go to the so src and type make, and so modify input dot dot and modify go1.sh, and finally so you should do the so go1.sh. Okay, so this is so how to run the program so it's the same as before. So this is a control data. Okay, I think so you can modify this, but so first you should follow this so configurations. So if you if your file so I'm not sure this is so identical with your now current file, but so please so change that. The first row shows the so number of meshes in each direction, nx, ny, and nz. So in this case, it's all of them are set to 100. Of course, you can change that. So for example, 128 or something, but now it's 100. And the second line is the so size of the mesh, each mesh in each direction. In this case, it's a cube with a so unit element size. And third line is the so, convergence criteria, so 10 to the minus 8. And the fourth line is the so, so number of thread. So here, we apply the so 18. Okay? It's a maximum number of threads for the read-bush, single socket of read-bush. And the last line shows the n color dot. So this one is a so color number. So in this case, it's 100. So 100 means a multi-color with 100 colors. So the rule for the specifying the so n color dot is the same as before in the previous one. So if it's more than 2, it's a multi-color, multi-coloring. And it's if it's 0, it's a Kato-Hiramaki. Minus one, reverse Kato-Hiramaki. And also, if it's less than minus two, it's a CMRCM. Okay, so you can, you don't have to so choose 100, but you can change that. And also, you may need to modify the JavaScript. So so you should be careful about that. So. So you should use so lecture 5 here, and so NCPU is 18 here, and the GT 25 here, and also OMP num thread is equal to 18. Okay. I think so this name is different. Okay, but so just so keep these. Okay, so please run the code. And so so just make sure so it's running.
Okay, I'll show you some
so demo on the screen. So you just follow me if you are not so familiar. So we start from the I have to log in. So here you just so do the so just make sure so your code really runs. Okay, so you don't have to do the so further running. Okay, I analyze the Raster GT25 and so I minus okay, OMP this C and multi core and GTL3. Okay, go to the SRC and the type make. Oops. Oops, what's happened? Yeah, it takes a longer time to compile than usual. Okay, so now it's done. So let's go to the run directory. So you can, so oops. Sorry, in the C directory, you don't have a lot of, sorry, I forgot to put. Okay, so this one should be, okay, I Just a moment. I forgot to put some of the. Okay, so this is the 100. And so I think you don't have enough Go file. So I think we should prepare more. Okay, so I just a moment. So Okay, so I'm afraid, so you don't have enough number of, so you don't have go1.sh on your run directory. So if you like, you can modify by yourself. But so I have prepared so some here, so you can copy from this directory to your own run directory. Okay. So actually, so you can find go1.sh. Okay. So it's so doing something similar. Okay. So please do this copy. So from my directory, so ompc multi-core l3 run so asterisk.sh to your directory. Sorry, very sorry for that. So if you done this, so you can modify go1.sh. But I think so this go1.sh is not so good because so lecture is 5 and this is a GT25. Okay. So thread is 18. So in this case we repeat the same computation 3 times. So I think you can delete these two. Okay. Or if you so keep these 5 here and you can so compare the computation time. Okay, so let's do that. Okay, so qsub go1.sh. So it takes a while because we are running the 5 times. Okay. So rb start. Okay, it's running. So you can see, so if you type rb start, so read wish schedule stop time is so July 28th Friday at 9 o'clock. So you have a so 22 days and 17 hours. So this is the schedule of the shutdown. So basically, so this so 9 o'clock is so Japan standard time. So it's so 1 hour ahead to the so Taiwan local time. So it's corresponding to the 8 o'clock in the morning. Okay. Yeah, here. Okay, it's now finished. So I think it's written in the error directory. Yeah, this one. So this is a test.error. Oops. So I think I don't remember the output. How's the output done? Okay, so this solver part is a computation part. So you can find solver in the test.error. Okay, so you can see, so this is the result of the computation time for the 5 time computations. So you can see it has some range. So the fastest one is the 1.444 second, but the slowest one is also 1.53. And so 3 of the so 5 times 5 running runs are 1.53. But so you can see that this one is the fastest one. So it depends on the situation, but so usually we have this type of the so some fluctuation of the computation time. So from the fastest to the latest. So for example, okay, I copy go1.sh to gg1.sh. So as I mentioned, so you can so don't apply the this NUMA CTL. Okay, so probably you can so delete this one. Oops. And the test. One error. And so you can run the, so this new shell script without a NUMA CTL, NUMA control. So I think it will take a rather longer time. And so you can so compare the computation time between the so with and without NUMA CTL. Okay, it's finished. So this is the time for the previous case, and this is the time for new case. So it's also not stable, but so you can see that generally the computation time is slower compared to the case with NUMA CTL. Okay, so that's why we recommend you to so add NUMA CTL. Okay, without NUMA CTL, so you can generally have a so slow competition time. Okay, so any questions for this part? So this is just running the code. So I will explain the so how to how was parallelized. So I just check the slide. Okay, there are no new questions. Okay, I'm not sure it's recorded now. Okay, it's recorded now. So, okay, let's go to the so detail of the so code. Okay, so the first is applying the OpenMP to the L2 solver, so on ICG solver. So dot product and DAXP and MATVEC, so we have no data dependency, so just insert the directives. So preconditioning part, so we need some coloring. So that's we just mentioned. So for example, so in the case of the matrix vector multiplication, so in the parallelization of the so PCG solver, which I showed this morning. So in that case, so we don't need so not so very special or complicated program model. So just insert the so pragma OMP parallel like this way. So this is actually enough. Okay, but in this case, thread number cannot be handled in the program. But so this may work well, or this may work better on GPU and many cores. And so from tomorrow, so you have also a lecture and some exercise on OpenACC using GPU. And so my colleague, Tetsuya, will recommend this type of parallelization using OpenACC. But here, so, and also in the case of the part of the forward substitution, so you can use this type of so parallelization. So this is a color part. So just inside the so coloring, color loop, so you can input the, this OpenMP pragma. So you can easily parallelize this loop for this color index. So this is also good. But so instead of that, so we do a little bit different strategy. Okay. So I'll show you the so detailed data. So this is the main program. It's same. So actually, so we may comment out the output UCD because it's a very expensive part. Okay, so this is a struct .h. So this part has not been so changed, but the only new thing is that this is a PSMB tool. Okay, you can see this is a number of threads. And this is a PCG.h. So basically this part has not been not so much changed as before. So we have an n-color dot, color index, and also we have a new two arrays, SMP index and the SMP index G. So you can see the size of the SMP index is a n-color dot times a PSMP dot. And the SMP index G size is also PESMP dot. It's also PSMP dot is also number of threads, or number of cores. And also old to new and new to old. So this is a table. So the first page is not changed. And the second page, we have some additional values. So you can see this as PSMP dot and the SMP index and the SMP index G. Okay. So SMP index and the SMP index G are used for the parallelization of the code for the ICC code. So SMP index is mainly for the array, for the loops with a data dependency. So this is mainly used for the forward and the backward substitution and the incomplete Cholesky factorization. And the second array, SMP index G, is a this is for loops without data dependency. So this is used for dot product, DAXP, and so SPMV. SPMV via sparse matrix vector multiplication. Okay, so this is a main program. So we just read the input data. So this time we have more data, so PSMP dot and n-color dot. So the rule for the n-color dot is also same as before. Okay, I think that we can skip this part. This is the same, just defining the cell matrix. And also, we skip this part. So let's jump to the Poisson. Okay. Actually, the first part is same. Okay. Beginning part is same. So this part, we define the some arrays and allocate the memory for each array. So next thing is according to the naive cell information, so we construct the initial matrix using IAL and INEL and INU and IAU. Okay, like this way. Okay, next thing is calling the functions related to the coloring, such as MC for multi-coloring, CM is for Katsuri-Maki, RCM is a reverse Katsuri-Maki, and CM-RCM. Okay, so actually this part is new. Okay, so after the renumbering, so we construct the two types of arrays, SMP index and the SMP index G. Actually, SMP index G is very simple, but SMP index is a little bit complicated. Okay. Basically, so SMP index array is used for loops with the preconditioning. Okay. So this yellow part shows how to use. Utilize this SMP index. So at the preconditioning part. So this is a loop for the coloring. So we have a parallelization under this. So we apply the pragma OMP parallel 4. Okay. So we don't show the detailed information of the loops here. But we have loops for IP equals 0 to PSM dot. So this is a loop for the thread. Okay, so outside is a loops for the colors, and inside we have a loops for the thread. Okay, so this is an explicit loops for the thread. So we can parallelize this part using so OMP. Okay. So IP1 is a IC. IC is a number of colors, color ID, multiplied by PSMIT. PSMIT is a total number of threads plus IP. Okay. So this is some index for SMP index. Okay. So this is IP1. So this on this color. And using this core or using this thread, so we do the computation for this I from SMP index IP1 to SMP index IP1 plus 1. Okay, so this part is so assigned to the each thread on each color. So we explicitly define the so assignment for the each thread by this way. So this SMP index provides us information for that. Okay, so actually, so this red part provides us how to define the so content of SMP index. Okay. So basically, so this is a so vector. Okay, the size is a so n color dot multiplied by PSMP dot plus one. Okay. Okay. So first we apply the so method. So the outermost loop is also about the n color dot. So n1 is a color index IC minus color index IC minus one. So n1 is a so number of meshes in the color IC. Okay. And this next one num num is a nn1 divided by PSMP dot. Okay, so this num shows us so average number of meshes on each thread at this color. Okay, so this is a actually this is a so so number of meshes here. Okay. So sometimes so nn1 is a so divisible by PSMP dot, but sometimes we have some so remainder. Okay, so remainder is so specified as nr, and so if so this nr is not equal to zero, so we add so several values to each thread. Okay. Thus, so at this stage, SMP index includes a number of meshes, so which is so operated, or which are so considered. On this thread at this color. Okay. So after that, we accumulate whole things from the so first color to the last color, and in each color from the first thread to last thread. Okay. Because so in the current configurations, the mesh number is continuous in each color, and it's very easy to specify this type of operations. So thus, we can specify the number of meshes and ID of meshes so in each thread at each color. So this is an array SMP index. So is that okay for you? It's a very simple arithmetic, not a mathematics. So if you want to use this SMP index for the so loop with the so preconditioning, you can just specify these loops. So that's it. So this is so how the SMP index works. This is some examples with five colors of eight threads. Okay. So this is the initial vector. So we have so five colors. So we denumber the meshes in the so according to this color. So in each color, we have eight threads. So we divide the so meshes in eight components. Okay, eight continuous components. And so each so this box will be so handled in each thread on each color. Okay, so on at each color, so they have some eight boxes. Okay, that's also so structured SMP index. So SMP index G is a it's more so straightforward and it's more simple. Okay, so because it's mainly for the so dot products and DAXP and MATBEC and some Poisson. So we can also read this, use this one to the Poisson. So it's very easy. So in this case, the NN, so basically, so just specify the meshes on each thread. Okay. So I cell dot divided by PS dot is a NN. So NN is a so number of meshes on each thread. Okay. So we just apply SMP index G to the each thread first, and so we may have some remainder. So in that case, we plus one for that. So small ID of meshes. So finally, we accumulate these values. So actually, so SMP index G is something like this. Okay. And so we just divide it into the 8 part. And so each part is so operated by each thread. So if you want to use this so SMP index G for the such computations, so this is how to use this. This is a loop starting for the so each thread, and so inside that we apply the so this so SMP index G from IP to IP plus one. So that's it. Okay, so any questions about SMP index and the SMP index G? Okay, so if no question, let's go to the next part. Okay, first one is so index L and index U. So actually this part is same as before. And also we calculate NPL and NPU. And so we can allocate item LU and AL and AU. Okay. And the next thing is that so specify the so content of item L and item U. And so we don't need INL, INU and IL, IAU anymore. Okay, this part is same. So next part is also very similar to the previous one, but the difference is here we introduce so parallelization by OpenMP for the matrix generation part. Because so as you notice, the formation of the matrix or assembling the matrix part is also embarrassingly parallel. Okay. So the all calculation is fully independent for each mesh. So in that case, we can easily parallelize this process. Okay, here we also introduced this double nested loops. The outer one is for the thread, and the inner one is for the loop for the SMP index G, which we just defined. Okay. So I cell is a so new number, and so we apply the old number for the IC0. Actually, rest of the part is the same as the before, but so please so be careful about this part. Okay. So I just enlarge the first part. So because this is a OMP pragma, so we need some declaration of the private variables. So because so this is a very long loop, so we have a lot of variables. So in this type of loops, so we should be very careful about the, so choosing the private variables. Okay? So if you want to do that, so sometimes so result could be changed, or you cannot get the right answer, or so every time you get a different answer. So anyway, it's not so good. So actually, so there are some preprocessors developed, but so actually it's very difficult to develop a very general preprocessor for selecting the or choosing the so private variables. So you have to be careful to develop this type of code. Okay, so you can see so many so private variables here. So this is a so double nested loop, so IP and ICL. So you can see these are so definitely private variables. And so ICL is transformed to IC0 using the new to old arrays. So IC0 is also a private variable because these computations are done in parallel manner. So IC0, ICL and IC0 are different to each thread. And so after this, so we define the ICN1 to ICN6. So these are also all private variables. And the coef is also coefficient values. So this is also private variables. So we have another, so several variables after that. So they are all private variables. I will show you the so details later. But anyway, so you can parallelize that this so matrix formation part, but so you need to be very careful to choosing the this type of values. Okay. Okay. I think so this is a Poisson part. It's not so different from the previous one. Actually, it's same. Okay. So this is a six neighbors. And so you can see this ISL, IEL, ISU, and IEU, they are also private variables defined here. Okay. And so, sorry. Okay, so this is also for the ICN. So we calculate coef. This is also private values. And so it's also, we have two choices. Lower triangular or upper triangular. So we have so another root here, J, and J is also a private variable. So this is the upper case. And after we repeat the so same types of computations here, so finally, so we have to calculate the so this right-hand side. So right-hand side, we need so to get the so location, II and JJ and KK. So these are also private variables. So you have to specify here. Finally, you get the so right-hand side. Okay, so after this, we apply the some boundary conditions, but that type part is also same. Okay, so I don't do that, I don't show that. Okay, so finally, we try to do some computations. So here, we can apply the so OMP get W time before and after ICCG functions. So if you so subtract these values, you can get the computation time. So this is a so beginning of the ICCG MC. So it's not so changed, but we have some new arrays here. Okay. So first one is a so initializing the arrays. So in order to initialize the arrays, so we use a SNP index G. Okay. So you have two loops here. So outer part, this loop for the thread is parallelized. So in this case, we have two loops. So we have to so declare two private variables here. And also this one is also IC factorization. So we have so the outer part is also n color color part, and so inside that color we can parallelize because also meshes on each color are independent. So we can apply the OpenMP parallelization on each color. Okay. So on each color we have also SNP index. So starting from this loop for thread. And so inside that, we have also loop for SNP index. Okay. So this parameter IP1 is defined by this way, IC multiplied by PSM plus IP. Okay. So it's a so starting point of this thread on this color. Okay. The rest is same. So you just be careful about specifying these two loops. Okay, so this is so just I show the so how to parallelize the incomplete modified Chorsky factorizations. So this is the original one, okay. And so this is so parallelized one, okay. So you can see, so this outer part is so loop for the color, and so in each color we can parallelize the loops. So we have two loops here, one is a thread, another one is a SNP index, okay. And so you can also specify the parameter here. Basically, so you can adopt the same thing for other type of operations, such as the forward and backward substitution. So in this case, you should be also careful about the choosing private variables. So IP and I, so they are the IP and I, and also IP1. So they are all private variables. And the var is also the private variables. And j is also the private variables. Okay, so it's very important. But you see, this IC, color number is so this is a global variable. So because it's a global computation, and it's so defined outside of the loops. So it's a global variable. Okay, so next thing is defining the initial residual. So this part is parallelized using SNP index G. Okay, so it's I have already shown. Okay, so this is a matrix vector part. So you just specify like this way. And next part is computing the binorm 2. So this part is also no dependency. So you can utilize this SNP index G. And so you should be careful to apply this reduction at this part. Okay, so I think it's a good point to take a break. So let's take a 10-minute break. So I'll check the